Hacking air-gapped machines with SATA, GPS trackers are vulnerable to serious attacks, and ransomware in Rust. All that coming up now on ThreatWire. Greetings, I am Shannon Morse, and this is ThreatWire for July 26, 2022. This is your summary of the threats to our security, privacy, and internet freedom. I have a special announcement. I will be at DEF CON. I'm so excited. It's happening the weekend of August 12th. I will be there for the entire convention, gonna be filming a special episode of ThreatWire. I'm also having a meetup, so I will post more details about that meetup to come soon. So keep an eye on the Patreon page and my social media. I'm at Snubs, that's S-N-U-B-S on Instagram and Twitter. That's where I'll post about it. So check those to hear about the announcement. And also a huge thank you so much for supporting my content, whichever way you do it. And thank you so much for letting me take a couple of weeks off to go visit my family. That's where I've been these couple of weeks. I just got home yesterday, and yes, my hair is naturally curly. I was on the beach for a week. I'm not even gonna fuss with it. So let's go ahead and get into today's news. I wanted to chat about some cool new hacks this week, so that's exactly what we are doing. Now, you are likely familiar with SATA, which is AKA Serial ATA Cables, which stands for Serial Advanced Technology Attachment. These are used as a connection for PC components, and I probably have like 30 of those laying around from past builds. The bus interface and IDE is quite standardized, and it's very common for adding additional data drives or optical drives to a machine as just a couple of examples. Well, it turns out you can actually use these to hack air-gapped machines because the cable can be used as a wireless antenna for radio signals at 6 gigahertz. This new air-gapped hack was discovered by our favorite air-gap researchers from the Ben Gurion University over in Israel. They published a paper describing this data exfiltration attack, which is published online right now. The researchers called this attack SATA-N? And it takes advantage of the SATA cables by using electromagnetic signals and transferring very small amounts of data from secured machines to a receiver, which can be no more than 1 meter away. Any more than that, and the data ends up having too many errors in it. When conducting these experiments, they found that VMs had lower signal quality, and increasing the distance between the air gap machine and the receiver also affects that same quality. The air gap machine would need to be infected via a rogue insider who has access to it, using, for example, a USB drive, like kind of like Stuxnet way back in 2010, to plant malware. Targeted data would be prepared by modulation and encoding. The malware can hijack software processes to reflect data with specific read and write functions. That data generates electromagnetic signals, and it could be captured via a radio receiver, hidden away but somewhat near the machine, which can demodulate that data, decode it, and send it over to an attacker. The researchers show a demo in their paper sending the word secret, S-E-C-R-E-T, to the receiver. Now, for critical environments where air gap machines are present, the researchers recommend preventing unauthorized access to air gap machines, using external RF monitoring to detect any anomalies at 6 gigahertz, and potentially polluting that frequency with random data if something out of the ordinary is detected. Data pollution, though, could increase the wear and tear of drives, since disk usage would also increase with that as well. Even though air gap hacks may not necessarily be something that we all worry about with our home PCs that are constantly connected to the internet through our ISPs, I do find that this research is really, really interesting, as it always shows us some kind of unique ways that somebody could intercept data from sensitive industries. In early July, hackers shared that they can unlock and start Hondas with flawed key fobs. Car hacks are pretty common, and we now have a second one for July. CISA, the U.S. Cybersecurity and Infrastructure Agency, published an advisory last week about GPS trackers found in many automobiles that could be hacked to gain control of the system, disable vehicle alarms, impact fuel supply with fuel cutoff commands, and allow for locational surveillance and routes used. The six vulnerabilities affect about 1.5 million vehicles worldwide with this MyCODIS MV720 GPS tracker installed. The advisory was posted as an industrial controls system advisory, and CISA says it could allow a remote attacker to gain control in those varieties of ways. The tracking devices only cost about $20, and they are used in many industries, including aerospace, energy, nuclear plants, and shipping. Vehicles affected were found in several different countries, including but not limited to Chile, Australia, Mexico, Ukraine, and more, including the United States. Over 100 countries use vehicles that have these GPS trackers installed. Many industries track their vehicles, including military and law enforcement, and if a malicious actor got access to that information, it could have major national security implications. The six vulnerabilities include, get this, a hard-coded master password, a broken authentication scheme, and a cross-site scripting flaw, just to name a few. Severity ranges from 6.5 all the way up to 9.8, and one of the flaws that stuck out to me is a pre-configured default password of 123456. I am serious. I cannot make that stuff up. Why are we still using this as a password? Come on, guys. CISA recommends technicians and manufacturers check the security audit report from BitSight for mitigations. No fix is currently available, but BitSight does recommend taking actions such as just disabling the device altogether or replacing it with a non-vulnerable product. Real quick, I want to say the biggest of shout outs to my Hush Puppy perk level patrons for sharing their fur baby photos and for the support. And a huge thank you to my newest patrons, including Kirsten, Igor, Christopher, Kirson, and Po Foon, who joined the Alliance over at patreon.com/threatwire. Let's go ahead and finish out today's episode with my last top story about some new cross-platform malware, which I might add, my Patreons chose this top story in a Discord poll, which you can do too if you join on Patreon. All right, Kaspersky security researchers have discovered a new ransomware family called Luna, which just so happens to be the name of my little black cat. She's adorable. She was named after Luna in Sailor Moon. Can anybody guess? I mean, it's pretty obvious, isn't it? This can be used to attack not only Linux, but Windows and ESXi systems as well. Also, does anybody have a problem with me pronouncing ESXi as eSexy? Because servers equal technolust, so I'm going to use that term. Luna is advertised on dark web ransomware forums to Russian-speaking actors, and the ad states that Luna only works with Russian-speaking affiliates. So Kaspersky's team suggests that it was made by native Russian speakers. Luna appears as a .luna extension, and it encrypts those files, but it has some limited capabilities via CLI as well. It uses a combination of Curve 25519 alongside AES for encryption. The ransomware is written in Rust, which is pretty platform agnostic, so that means they did not have to make many changes to the source code to port it to different platforms. That also means it will evade static code analysis. Now, very little is known currently about Luna victims, but Kaspersky is actively monitoring their footsteps on the dark web. The new ransomware discovery shows that a new trend is also brewing of malicious groups using Rust and Golang to hit several platforms with the same ransomware. The first two to use Rust were Black Cat and Hive, but this trend might grow in popularity as more attackers develop ransomware in this programming language. My YouTube channel is youtube.com/Shannon Morse for everything from tech reviews to security tutorials. By the way, I've got a Pixel 6a review in the works right now. I'm so excited to share it with you. Don't forget to like and subscribe to Hack5 as well. I'm Shannon Morse, and I will see you on the internet.